lots of optimization algorithms have been proposed to solve optimization problems in real life. This video is based on a new optimization algorithm named as Mayfly optimization algorithm. In this video, we will try to understand what is this new algorithm all about, how it is working, and various mathematical models used to represent Mayfly's behavior, their movements, and other activities in this algorithm. So first, we will start with introduction. Mayfly optimization algorithm is inspired by the flight behavior and the mating process of mayflies in real life. This algorithm is the modification of particle swarm optimization algorithm. Mayfly optimization algorithm also combines the advantages of evolutionary algorithm and swarm intelligence algorithms. So as this algorithm combines the advantages of swarm intelligence algorithms and evolutionary algorithm, it forms powerful hybrid algorithmic structure, and we can use this algorithm to solve both continuous and discrete problems, single objective and multi-objective optimization problems. So as this algorithm is inspired by the flight behavior and the mating behavior of mayflies, so first we will try to understand the mayflies' behavior in real life so that we can easily understand how this algorithm is working. Mayflies are the aquatic insects and also known as fish flies and off-winged flies in United Kingdom. Over 3,000 species of mayflies are estimated worldwide, and they appear mainly during May month in UK. You can see we have certain features for mayflies. As you can see here, long tail, transparent wings that do not fold. They do not have mouth. In the nymph stage, they have fully developed mouth and they eat algae. But you know, the lifespan for the mayflies is shorter. As you can see here, male mayfly can live up to 2 days, and female mayflies dies after laying eggs within 5 minutes. They do not have time to eat and they never develop functional mouth, and they spend most of their time in reproduction. Now you can see here we have nuptial dance. Swarm of male also perform mating dance that is known as nuptial dance over the water surface when any female mayfly is around. Here nuptial dance is just up and down patterns. If any female mayfly is attracted toward the male mayfly, then they fly into the swarm and mate with the male in the air, and after adult pairing, the female mayfly drop eggs on the water surface and dies. Eggs hatch within 2 weeks, and after that we have nymph stage. Mayflies spend several years growing as aquatic nymph, and when mayfly is ready, they leave the nymph skin and emerge into an adult within 24 hours. An adult mayfly lives for a couple of days. As you can see here, the lifespan for the mayflies. Now we will try to understand the single objective mayfly optimization algorithm. So first, you know, in real life everything is quite natural. Mayflies can easily move and they can perform other activities. But here in this algorithm we have the virtual mayflies. So here we have virtual environment, and we are using the mathematical models to calculate their position, velocity and all. So for algorithm simplicity, here we have certain assumptions. First, it is assumed that after hatching from eggs, mayflies are already adult and fittest mayflies survive. So we will not consider the nymph and other stages. So after hatching from eggs, we have adult mayflies and fittest mayflies survive. And for the fitness function is used to calculate which one is fittest and which one is not. So first step is population initialization. We will initialize the population for the male and female mayflies in the problem space. So first initialize the population and the velocity of male mayflies in the problem space. Here you can see the male mayfly's position in the population is denoted with xi. X is used to represent the position, and I is the total number of agents, or you can say the mayflies. Here I is 1 to population size. So x1 means the position for the first mayfly, and this is for the second, and so on. After that, we will initialize the population for the female mayflies, and hereby is used to denote the position for the female mayflies in the problem space. And you can see the velocity. And after that, we will calculate the fitness value for the each mayfly. And here, each mayfly position represents the solution to the problem. So you can see here, first we will initialize the population for the female and male mayflies randomly in the problem space. And after that, using a cost function, or you can say the objective function, we will calculate the fitness values, or you can say we will evaluate their performance. After that, in step 4, we will select the best mayfly among all. Here, this is the global best mayfly, which is best among all. So when you will calculate the fitness value for each mayflies, then we will consider the minimum value among all as the global best mayfly. After that, we will check the stopping criteria. If the stopping criteria is met, then we will display the best solution that you obtained in the previous iteration. If stopping criteria is not met, then we will repeat the loop. In step 6, we will update the position and the velocity for both male and female mayflies. And we can change the position by adding the velocity in the current position. And as we know that the male mayflies gather in the swarm, so we can change the position for the male mayflies by adding some velocity in the current position. So you can see here, this is the current position, and you can see the velocity added. And this is the new position that we obtained for the male mayfly. Here X is the male mayfly position, I is the male mayfly number, that is the in the population we have n mayfly, so it is used to represent the number. And after that, V is the velocity, T is the current iteration, and T plus 1 means the value that we will use in the next iteration. And after that, you can see here, as you can see, we added some velocity. So for velocity, we will use this mathematical model to calculate velocity. So as we know that they perform nuptial dance to attract female mayflies, so it is assumed that they cannot develop great speed and move constantly. And here you can see the velocity can be computed for the male mayflies using this equation. Here this is the current velocity, and you can see the current position, and this is the personal best mayfly position, and this is the global best mayfly position, and these are the constant. And here you can see here RP is the Cartesian distance between mayfly and personal best position, and this is the Cartesian distance. RG is the Cartesian distance between mayfly and the global best mayfly, and we can calculate the distance using this formula. And here this corresponds to P best and G best. And after that, you can see here we can update the P best position using this. If the fitness value that we obtained for new position is better than older one, then we will consider the new, else we will consider the older one. And global best is the minimum fitness value among all. For algorithm proper functioning, the best mayfly continue to perform their nuptial dance, and they keep changing their velocities. And this is the formula that we can use to change their velocity. This is the nuptial dance coefficient, and here this is the normally distributed random value. And after that, we will update the velocity and the position for the female mayflies. As we know that the female mayflies do not gather in the swarm, so they fly toward the male mayfly in order to breed. So we can change their position by adding some velocity in the initial position. So in the current position, add some velocity. And how we can calculate the velocity using this mathematical model. Now you can see here, using this formula, we can calculate the velocity for the female mayfly. If the fitness value of female mayfly is greater than the male mayfly, then we will use this equation. It means that female mayfly is attracted toward male mayfly. Else, we will use this one. It means that the female mayfly is not attracted toward the male. And here, this is the distance between the male and the female. Mayflies, and R is the random value, and FL is the random walk. So when the female mayfly is not attracted toward the male mayfly, then we will perform here the random walk. And in this algorithm, the random walk and the nuptial dance is used to balance the exploration and exploitation phase in order to escape from the local optimum. After that, in step 7, we will evaluate the solution. Yeah, as you can see in the previous step, we updated the position and the velocity for the male and the female mayflies. After that, we will calculate the fitness value for each, and then we will rank the mayflies according to their fitness value. Suppose we have 4 mayflies for male and 4 mayflies for female, and suppose the second mayfly in the male is best. It has minimum value, so this is the first best mayfly, and this is the second best male mayfly, and this is the third best male mayfly, and so on. For the female, you can see here, this is the first best female mayfly, and this is the second best female mayfly, and so on. Now in step 9, we have mutation phase. Here the mating of the mayfly is done, and from genetic algorithm we used here crossover operator. This is used to represent the mating process between the two mayflies. Here you can see we already ranked the mayflies according to their fitness value, and you can see this one is the best among all. You can see the first best, second best, third best, and fourth best for male and female. After that, you can see here we will select the patent, one from male and one from female, and the best from and best female breed with the best male, and second best female breed with the second best male, and third best female breed with the third best male, and so on. As first best female is attracted toward first best male, so like that we will perform the crossover, and we will select the parent, one from the male and one from the female, and selection is can be random or we can done based on their fitness values. After crossover, we will obtain 2 offsprings. As you can see here L is the random value, and male represent the male partner and female represent the female partner. After that, we will evaluate their offsprings, and then we will separate the offsprings to male and female randomly, and then we will create merged population, and we will keep the best male and female mayfly, and then we will replace the birth solution with the best solution, and again we will update the personal best and the global best solution, and then we will check the stopping criteria. If current iteration is equal to maximum number of iteration, then stop and display the best solution, else repeat from step 6. So that's all about this video. So in this algorithm, we used nuptial dance and random flight to balance the exploration and exploitation phases to escape from the local optimum. And we tested on 38 benchmark function and compared with 7 algorithms, and it obtained better results as compared to other. So that's all about this video. If any question, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.